Welcome to Dancing with Tay. Today, we're going to be talking about some good old tech news. But first, don't forget to subscribe, hit notification bell, like, and leave a comment below. Now, we're not going to do no joke for today. I know you guys are disappointed, but I'm just kidding, though. So, here it goes. Why can't you ever tell a joke around glass? Come on. Think about it. It could crack up. Google has discontinued the Google Pixel 4a and the Google Pixel 4 XL ahead of the Google Pixel 5. There's nothing out of the ordinary. This is like Google. Google user gets rid of the last phone lineup before continuing the new lineup. Speaking of new, Google just released the Google Pixel 4a. I know, finally, right? The Google A line is shaped up to put Google's flagship to shame, shame, and shame. What I mean is the consumers are getting a much better value for Google's mid-range phones over their flagships. Not to mention, the performance isn't that much different. The A series phone users only miss out on one or two features that the flagships have. Those one or two features used aren't that important. They have the same exact cameras as the flagship versions. Google also has Google Pixel 5 coming. You are probably seeing the rumor renders online, but that's not how Google Pixel 5 is going to look in the end. The design has a complete overhaul and it's just for the better if you ask me. From what we know, there is no big forehead or chin, thank goodness. There is not no notch in the bezels. Looks like they are going to be a little smaller this year. Definitely more screen real estate with a punch-hole selfie camera in the top left corner. The Google Pixel 5 is also rumored to have a 120Hz refresh rate. Google is doing the same thing with the Pixel 5 that they did with the Google Pixel 4a. They've only given us one version. They're cutting down on costs for themselves so that they can cut down on costs for us, the consumers. They're doing this by only delivering one phone. That makes perfect sense. Unlike other manufacturers that cut down on costs and cut corners for themselves anywhere they can, but continuously increase the cost of the devices for the consumers. Sound like a few companies I could think of. The version of the Google Pixel 5 were going to be like the Google Pixel version of the XL. The big news right now as far as a new Pixel device is concerned is that Google finally listened to everyone. We've been complaining for years that Google's been putting too much stock in their own hype, tooting their own horn. What I mean is Google has good, reliable phones, but they've been overcharging them. While they're good phones, they're not worth $800 or $900, in my opinion. And I can really tell you, I bought the Google Pixel, the first one, and it was just ridiculously too high. No features or none of that stuff like you would get from Samsung. Anyways, let me stop ranting. Google will use a Qualcomm Snapdragon 765 and not either of the 865 series processor, which will cut down on costs tremendously. You'll hardly notice a difference, if any at all, because of how well optimized Google's phones are. For those that aren't aware, anytime you see a processor number with a G in it, that means that the phone will be 5G capable. Finally, for the price and the release date, going back to what I said about Google listening to us about their prices, the Google Pixel 5 is rumored to cost $699. If this is true, this will be the cheapest flagship that Google has ever made. Let me be clear. I said Flagship because back when Google was making the Nexus phones, they weren't part of the Flagship game yet. Google stepped into the Flagship territory once they start making the Pixel phones. The release date for the Pixel 5 is slated for October 8th, 2020. Alright guys, thank you for checking me out today. Don't forget to subscribe by clicking over here. If you want to see some more good old tech news or other random shows, click over here and I'll get back with you again.